present the State of the University Address. It's my great honor to present to you Dr. Sidney A. McPhee.
Thank you, Dr. Martell, and good morning. As always, I'm truly delighted to welcome each of you to our annual fall faculty meeting. I have always approached the beginning of each new academic year with tremendous anticipation. And today, I stand before you with the same excitement and enthusiasm that I felt when I first began my tenure here as president of this great institution 12 years ago. We enter our second century with a very clear mission, and that mission is to increase our already considerable commitment to student success, and in doing so, helping provide even more college graduates for Tennessee's workforce. This campus heritage is deeply rooted in its founding as a normal school, a school established to train teachers. And how fitting that we begin the year with the dedication of a state-of-the-art facility for our College of Education after 100 years. And of course, a fitting closure to our centennial celebration was the groundbreaking in May of this year of our $147 million science building project. This 250,000 square foot facility to be ready in time for the spring semester 2015, hopefully earlier than that, represent one of the most significant investments, one of the most significant, ladies and gentlemen, investment made towards the enhancement of science and technology education in the entire state of Tennessee. Now, as the centennial celebration ended, and we began to look to the future, we announced a multi-million dollar centennial campaign, capital campaign. This effort is the largest in the university's history. Today, ladies and gentlemen, we have already have more than $55 million pledged towards the campaign goal. And as a result of our early successes, we have raised the original goal, campaign goal, from $61 million to $80 million. The highlight, of course, of our efforts to date was the announcement of the $10 million commitment made by our 1966 MTSU grad, Mr. Andrew Woodfin Woody Miller. He is given the largest gift from an alumnus in the university's history. As we embark on our second century, we are well positioned to build on our successes and solidify our position as Tennessee's best comprehensive university. But ladies and gentlemen, colleagues, there's much more to do if we are to reach our full potential. Last academic year, I asked for the development of a plan that will allow for our enrollment growth and provide strategic directions in that area that will allow us to grow deliberately and in an economically feasible way. In 1993, a noted scholar of higher education administration, Vincent Tinto, said universities must do more than recruit solid students. They must also build a culture that enables them to succeed. Tinto put forward three very simple principles of effective retention, and they are very simple. Put student welfare ahead of other institutional goals. In other words, work first to take care of students, and most likely, everything else will follow suit. Recently, we have initiated some programs to help improve student success on our campus. For an example, this past year, we have started an academic alert program which allows faculty to communicate directly with students about classroom performance and follow up on concerns. Last year, ladies and gentlemen, more than 27,000 early alerts were entered into this digital system, and many of them followed up. We have assigned all incoming students with academic counselors this year, in addition to their standard academic advisors. Now, while advisors change each time a student changes his or her major, the student's academic counselor is the one person that they can turn to for help from enrollment through graduation, regardless of what they are studying, regardless of their major. We must, at MTSU, we must work to develop such a community devoted to learning, growth, and service. And we hold these values dear, that there is a simple phrase that convey them. I am true blue. Each time we repeat these words, we express not only the ideals we wish to share with our students, but also our commitment to the student-centered culture that we're building and we are known for on this campus. New students at Convocation take the True Blue Pledge. It commits them to the practice of the core values of this community, the values of honesty, integrity, respect for diversity, engagement in the community, and committing to reason, not violence. So in short, True Blue stands for the very best of what Blue Raiders expect from one another, that together we're committed to the progress and the success of our university. But without good actions to stand behind these words, it will be meaningless. So let me share with you just a few examples of those who we believe are true blue. If you would ask, ladies and gentlemen, Chad Lassiter, he would say that Dr. Joey Gray, a professor in the College of Behavioral and Health Sciences, is true blue. Joey and Chad, would you stand? There they are in the back. Let's give them a round of applause. Remain standing. Please remain standing. Chad says that Dr. Gray, and I quote, has meant so much to me and has helped me to overcome obstacles others put in my way. She is the true example of what a professor should strive to be. Chad goes on to say, and I quote, I first met her when I was on academic probation and had to appeal to get back in school. She was the one who took a chance on me, and she believed in me. Chad continues, she has helped me to overcome so many challenges, and I know if it was not for her believing in me, I would not be graduating in December. Thank you, Dr. Gray, for being true blue. If you would ask Tiffany Vance, she would say that Dr. Lawana Fisher, a professor in the University College, is true blue. Lawana and Tiffany, would you please stand? Yeah, they are over there. Please remain standing. Tiffany says that Dr. Fisher made her success as a student possible. Tiffany works full-time in a demanding job and is a single mother. She needed to take algebra online and asked Dr. Fisher for her permission to take the course online. Dr. Fisher gave Tiffany a very candid and direct warning on the intensity of the class. She gave her permission, however, but also committed to work with her through the frequent reviews. From time to time, Tiffany would ask for additional questions by email, and Dr. Fisher took the time to provide videos of her answers. And Tiffany wrote to me, quote, "That was so unexpected. I can't imagine how many students she must have at any given time, and yet she took the time to do that for me," end of quote. Ladies and gentlemen, Tiffany passed this class with a grade of B. She gave me permission to give that information. Dr. Fisher, thank you for being true blue. And if you would ask Tyree Rump, he would say that Mr. Ben Jones, an assistant director in accounting services, is... Let's do that one more time. You are true blue. I'll repeat that. If you would ask Tyree Rump, he would say, Mr. Ben Jones, an assistant director in accounting services, is? Very good, ladies and gentlemen. Ben and Tyree, would you please stand? Where are you? Let's give them a round of applause and remain standing. Tyree, who came to MTSU from Detroit, struggled with his studies shortly after arriving here. And in the process of withdrawing from the university, he met Mr. Jones. Mr. Jones met with Tyree and promised to help turn him in the right direction. He meets with Tyree once a week, every week, over lunch, serving as a mentor and tutor and a life coach. Voluntarily, it's not part of his job. Mr. Jones is part of our business office, and as I said, his responsibilities do not call for him to directly work with students. Yet, he has committed his time and talent to helping Tyree succeed. And last but certainly not least, I would like to recognize a special group of true blue individuals. If you ask any Blue Raider athlete about athletic staff, they would say that these individuals are definitely true blue. During the spring 2012 semester, very impressive here, 145 of its 293 student athletes earned a grade point average of 3.0, ladies and gentlemen. 145 out of 293. And 58 made the university's dean's list. 18 student athletes attained a 4.0 GPA. This past year, the Sun Belt Conference named 62 Blue Raiders to the prestigious commissioner's list for their exemplary academic records. The NCAA bestows public recognition awards upon teams that post academic performance scores among the top 10% in their sports. MTSU has won two such recognition in football and in men's golf, with both sports being singled out for the second year in a row. And only 12 other Division I programs were honored by the NCAA in 2012, and among those, schools like Air Force, Duke University, University of Miami, Rice, Rutgers, Vanderbilt, and ladies and gentlemen, on top of that list, MTSU. Students will remember those faculty and staff members who challenged them the most, not the least. They will remember the people who reached out, who connected with them. And that is why I ask each of you to remember that no matter what you do, as a member of this university, faculty, staff, or administration, all of us, ladies and gentlemen, have a responsibility for student success. I want to thank you for your attention today. It's been an honor and certainly a blessing for me to be a part of this just wonderful community. I'd rather be no place, no other place, than right here with you in Murfreesboro, Tennessee, at Middle Tennessee State University. Thank you so much. Go True Blue.